And narration option is set to lock.
You an enemy. All them lies you telling, I can't let that be the end of me. No, no. Probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play, all these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency. Let's go. Don't make me jog your memory. I did upgrade you, then upgraded the world. How they forgetting me? Please make it make some sense to me. How you talking about the greatest? Still ain't mention me. Them bands, I want the symphony. 15 in it, went instantly. Lately I've been catching plays, it's like it's meant to be. I got rich in the pandemic, meant to be. Don't do too much, I keep it simple. You clout chasing, trying to make the people feel you. Boys need to slow it down, I'm talking real screw. Penthouse at the top with the clear view. Oh, look, I don't like your energy. I don't like that. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency. You an enemy. All them lies you telling, I can't let that be the end of me. No, no, probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play, all these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency. Let's go. You not my kind, not no kin to me. Heard you told my girl about all of them that's DMing me. Why they hogging up the recipe? Heard they talking like I can't let Ken Wallace get ahead of me. Know your heart full of jealousy. All that acting tough, damn, this must be a parody. Okay, 101 ain't no comparing me. Okay, wait, 2-on-2, that's like 4-2, they be sharing me. Okay, they working like the red dude. Rent, got them going, that's what I'm into. Yeah, if I'm in it, then I own it, not a rental. No, I've been plotting on the lamb and the Benz cool. Yeah, oh, yeah. Yeah, I don't like your energy. I don't like that. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency. You an enemy. All them lies you telling, I can't let that be the end of me. No, no. Probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play, all these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency. Let's go.
Father, who art in heaven, I love when you toss me blessings. You never throw interceptions, I catch them like Odie Beckham. Halting up the devil when built like Tiana Teller. And balling at 27, I feel like Iman Shumpert. Know there's a disconnect when the sheep start to lead the shepherd. The weak start to be aggressive, the streets start to be the reverend. Bragging about first class, seated on 9-11. They spirits are not united, a legion, my soul forever. I murder my adolescents, assault with a friendly weapon. I verbally dissect them to help them get back together. Wanting the stranger things, I handle it like 11. My point is I guard the kids. I should play for the Celtics. Watch how I Euro step them and curry them like I'm stepping. Whenever I'm in your town, the Warriors in your presence. I manifest my endeavors. I'm blessed and I'm getting better. I walk amongst living legends. Coach Contra will live forever.
New goals, baby boo. Got my wrist in it.
From beautiful South Florida, there's a look at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. Today we hit week 10, and we've got a good one in store between the Cleveland Browns and the Miami Dolphins. The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. They start on the ground with Nick Chubb. And he's got some space here. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. A big chunk of yardage there, 37 yards.
And that's definitely the way to get things started. That's the way it was drawn up in the locker room, in pregame, and everything. And they got it done right away, running the ball for a big gain.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. They run it again with Chubb. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. Credit Melvin Ingram, able to get into the backfield and make the stop. A tale of two extremes. First carry, he went for a bundle. His second goes backward.
And how many times have we seen that happen? Because you get that big carry, and you come back, and you're all fired up, and sometimes you force a run a little bit, right? Trying to break off that big carry again, and instead, it works opposite.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. They go up the middle with Chubb. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. This will be a loss of three and now a much tougher third down moment.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for. One of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Third and 15 here after the first and second down plays went in the wrong direction. Now the Dolphins are going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. The Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Off of play action, it's Watson. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Keon Crossan. And he'll get this back across the midfield, striping down to the 47-yard line. Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against, an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football. But at the same time, you're looking at them and going, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. Officially, it's a... That's going to bring up second and 11. Looking to pass. Tua. They set up the screen for Henry. And the tackle going to be made at the 38. This is third and one. Very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. Try to run for the first with Henry. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs. The Dolphins sit 6-3 on the year. And they've been playing their best football of the year. Winners of four in a row.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
They keep it with Henry on first down. And he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. Second down coming up. This defense, Charles, really played well in that win a week ago.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week, because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Again, it's Henry. And he's going to take this down close to a first down at the Browns 25. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. On third down, Henry. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. Move the chains, a gain of seven on third down. If you make the stop there, maybe you hold them to three on this opening drive. They didn't get the stop.
Yeah, new set of downs now. Now you're worried about, just as you pointed out, not just giving up three, possibly giving up six. Let's see what they decide to do here, because they've got to change up what they have been doing. It hasn't been working.
A first down carry for Henry. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. Here's Tua. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, he certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
Here we go. Play number nine on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. And the Browns are going to take over at their own 13-yard line.
And that felt like a little extra pressure on that third down attempt, and their mistake cost them points because they're inside the red zone. So you know you've got at least a field goal waiting for you. And in this case, they end up with nothing.
The Browns drive about to get started. Well, they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back, and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception. What interception? It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful.
Now it's second and nine. And Chubble trying the middle here. Call it a gain of five that time, and they'll be left with a third and about four.
He had to fight for every yard on that run. Shook himself free of a tackle and kept fighting, even with the rest of the defense closing in on him. That's the kind of effort you'll take every single time.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. On third down, it's Nick Chubb. And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
That'll be a 41-yard punt, 4 yards there on the return, and it'll be Dolphin football.
On the double.
First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And they come into this one riding that nice long win streak. And remember, next weekend is an open week for them. So if they can get the win here, a lot of momentum into that time off.
It certainly is. And if you're wondering if anybody's saying, boy, this is coming at a bad time, we want to keep playing, the answer can be yes. Because when teams are on a hot streak, they want to keep going. But what the veterans are telling the young guys in the locker room, an open week is always good, guys. Take it, and let's go with it. You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Let's go.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. Now Tua. Throwing for the out route, he finds Wilson. And they'll get this down to the 42-yard line.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
On first down, Tagovailoa. And he rifles one incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Tua going to throw. And the Browns pressure gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. Sione Takitaki charges in there hard and drops him for a loss of 12 from that outside linebacker position.
Ready.
So now after the sack, Tua and the Dolphins staring at a third and long. Off of play action, Tagovailoa. Oh, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's fourth down. Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. And they were winners the last time they took the field, which was 2 weeks ago. They had the open week last week. So this is a squad that should be really refreshed and ready to roll.
I would agree, because when you get that open week after a victory, it does wonders for everyone. Obviously, your body, you get a chance to heal up, but your mind as well. You feel good about winning, so now you can get away from it for a few days, put down the playbook, you know, turn off the film. Just be you. Enjoy that time away, and then you come back ready to go.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Faking the give. Now Watson. Man open. That's Anthony Schwartz. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A big gainer there on the catch and run, 37 yards.
This offense has been slow to get started, but that play will certainly give them a little bit of life. Maybe the late wake-up call that they had been seeking.
The big play has them all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Now Chubb running right. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. A reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll send you up to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there, and he'll have stats and scores from a busy Sunday in the NFL. Second down, here's Chubb again. And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line. 48 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. And again, it's Chubb. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. gets a give to Chubb. And a very determined run there as he'll take this all the way down to the 27. Good effort. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Could we get a touchdown in this first half after all? It's first and 10. They'll fake the handoff. Now Watson. Touchdown, Browns! Randall Cobb, his first touchdown on the year. And the Browns will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point by York is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. A short kick taken at the 18. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. At the line ready for their next drive. With this slim deficit closing in on the end of the first half, we'll see if they can move this at least into field goal range and try to get three out of this drive. 30 seconds remain in this first half as they come up here first and 10. Tua sets up to pass it. And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now, just under 30 seconds to go in this first half.
Okay, great.
After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10.
Wait.
Going to the air, Tagovailoa. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. Or so miles northwest of world-famous Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. Today we hit week 10 and we've got a good one in store between the Cleveland Browns and the Miami Dolphins. The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. Hill is going to take it out of the end zone. A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he'll fight forward on the straight ahead running for just a couple of yards, second down. Well, this defense, very strong in that victory from a week ago.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
And they'll look to avoid an early three and out here on third and four. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Out route, and this is Henry with a catch. And he won't get close. Only a yard, fourth and three.
Well, able to get the completion, but unfortunately not able to get the third down conversion there on that play.
And I like how the defense approached that one. They knew where the first down marker was, and they decide whatever you want to have, you can. You're just not going to get the first down. Excellent tackling right there.
A 41-yard punt there with no return. And the Browns will take over first and 10. In the Browns now with a first and 10 at their own 16. They begin this drive with Chubb, and this defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. The tackle made by Alandon Roberts.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Now a play fake, and it's Watson. Going for the deep ball. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Javon Holland. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line.
So they tried to take the deep shot there, but this defense up to the task.
And a lot of times when you air a ball out like this, if it does get intercepted, there's going to be a lot of space out there to set up a return. And remember, you've got five big offensive linemen out there playing on their feet in open space. Not a skill most of them possess that allows for extra yardage on their situations. Just call a simple run, get a few yards to begin the series, and set yourself up for something bigger on second down.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
first quarter.